Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new, my name is Adriana, and welcome to the baking. Today's video will be a Q&A for my 1 year postdoc BBO. So the questions that I'll be answering today is the questions that I asked the people on my surgery page to see, you know, what they wanted to know about my journey. And yeah, so let's get into it.
You must be made for me. Patience is everything. In and out, in and out. Arguing, trifling, difficult. Make more, I don't know.
So my first question is, how do I feel? I feel absolutely amazing. I can definitely say that life after BBO has been transforming. I feel like I've changed so much mentally, physically, emotionally. I've, you know, opened myself up to like different experiences. I would say both good and bad. But it's definitely a journey. It's a journey. and would I recommend it to anybody else? I feel like it's up to you. I feel like, you know, if you are looking for certain like life upgrades, and if you are strong enough to deal with the emotional changes that come with having a BBO, then I would definitely say go for it. I feel like there's a lot of things that people don't talk about with life after BBO. Or maybe it's just my experience. I don't know. But I would definitely say there have been more goods though. But having a BBO definitely comes with pros and cons. And if you guys want a video of the pros and cons of having a BBO, just leave it in the comment section down below. My next question is, was the hospital and recovery home clean? Yes, I would say that they were definitely clean, and they definitely kept a clean standard all the way around. The hospital is very sanitary. As far as the structure, it's a little different. I feel like our hospitals in America are really, really big, and theirs is really, really small. But everything was sanitized. You know, you seen people washing their hands, cleaning, changing their gloves, wearing the, you know, like the suits. When I went into the surgery room, everybody was fully covered and sanitized with gloves, and all of the equipment was sanitized. It came straight out the plastic and stuff like that. I feel like that is the beauty of being able to see the surgery room, or the room that you will be operating in before you go under. So I feel like that made a difference. It was scary. It was very, very scary, but it did make a difference, like just knowing that the facility was clean. As far as the recovery home is very, very clean. They do the same thing, the same procedures as the hospital. They're cleaning, they're sanitized, they're wearing the right garments, changing their gloves when working with everybody. They put you on a routine. I actually like that, like a medical routine, like for your medicines and stuff like that. Your massages, everything was definitely up to par. And that definitely made me a lot more comfortable with picking Dr. Plaza's team to take care of me. My next question is, did you experience fluff? How and when? I did experience fluff, and I would say that my fluff period was about 3 to 4 months. Before that, I feel like my butt was so hard. I didn't like it. I was just like, oh, when is it gonna, you know, like when is it gonna get soft and stuff like that. But I did know from experiences of others that I would go through a fluff period. Like example, like my mom has had a BBO, so I watched her go through her whole healing phase. So I understood the process. And it's just kind of like, it's kind of like the fat settling in, you know, and like just, I guess, getting used to the placement. I don't know why you fluff. I just know that you fluff, you know. Do I still swell? At 1 year post-op, I do not swell anymore. Yeah, I don't swell anymore. But I still go through regular woman bodily bloating, or like if I eat something, I'll bloat. Or if it's that time of the month, I'll bloat and my stomach is not flat. But all of that can be taken care of with like proper health and diet and stuff like that. So I've been working on that, getting my diet together and like working out and stuff like that. Go through random pains or complications. At 1 year post-op, no. However, during the healing process, you do go through like random sharp pains out of nowhere. And you're just like, ah, it just feels like a spasm. And it might be like in your back or in your stomach or in your butt. Like, so I did go through random sharp pains. But from the experience of others, that's normal and part of the healing process. I also experienced itching. Itching is also part of the healing process as well too. Like, girl, you're gonna itch. You're gonna itch, and your best friend is gonna be Benadryl. I'm talking about the cream, the pills, the gel. Like, Benadryl is going to be your best friend when you start itching. And I would say that you're gonna start itching around like 2.5-3 months. Ooh, girl. And when I say you itch, like, you like itch. Like, I was patting my faja and my board because I was itching so bad. But Benadryl is gonna be your best friend. Do you think that Dr. Plaza is the one for butt projection? I do think that Dr. Plaza did a nice job with giving my body projection. Well, my butt. He did a great job with giving my butt projection. And yeah, girl, I have no complaints. I sent him, well, I showed him before I went into the surgery room. I showed him exactly what I wanted and how I wanted it. And I definitely feel like he gave me the results that I was looking for according to my body and my body type. He asked me if I wanted a big butt or if I wanted a little butt. And I was like, I just want a little medium butt, you know. I don't want too much. When did your stomach stay completely flat? I would say that my stomach was flat from the beginning. I just experienced a lot of bloating. I mean, not bloating, but swelling. So with swelling, it's just all about your compression techniques and taking your time. Like, don't rush the healing process. Wear your faja for 6 months. They say 3 to 6, but baby, I'm telling you 6. Wear your faja. Yeah, my stomach was pretty flat from the jump. I did have like a little pooch before. So when I, like, after surgery, I had like a small little pooch or whatever, but that went away. I would say like after the first month and a half, 2, and my stomach was like flat. And but I was still experiencing swelling. So swelling is not gonna go away until like 6 months. Like, it gradually slowly stops like getting as severe, like your body goes down. But I would say that I still experience swelling up to like 6 months. What kind of meds did Dr. Plaza prescribe? He gave me some stool softeners. He gave me pain medication, which, baby, it sucked. The pain medication sucked. Like, I was good on popping 2 Tylenol, extra strength, rapid release, every 4 hours, even though the label says 6. But I was popping them every 4 hours. Like, I don't care. And I was drinking a lot of water. A lot of water, a lot of bee juice, pineapple juice. Those are going to be your best friend in your healing process. So the pain medicines didn't really do too much for me. So I was doing Tylenol. extra strength, heavy on the extra strength and rapid release. My next question is, what was my compression method? I can actually do a whole video on this if you guys want it. If you guys want a whole video on my compression method and a detailed how I did it and how I achieved my results using my compression method, then just leave compression method in the comment sections down below and I would definitely give you guys a detailed video on how I did it. And also remember that you can only, after surgery, you can only be out of your faja for an hour a day. Like, so 23 hours, you need to be in your faja. So that hour, you need to be washing your faja, you need to be washing your ass, taking a shower, doing everything that you need to do. But make sure that you put that faja back on. Like, put that faja back on. Because the longer that you wear your faja, like, is going to affect your results. So your faja, your massages, and how you eat, and your regimen after you heal matters so much. Don't let them folks think that you can't gain weight after a BBL, baby, because you can. And I experienced that. Like, so yeah, what faja did I use? So I got two fajas from Colombia. I got my first stage faja and my second stage faja from Colombia. All my other fajas I got from Snatchmans. And I'll link them in my description box down below as well too. I absolutely love that company. I highly recommend them. Their fajas are quality. And girl, they helped me achieve these fine results. So, yeah. So, I'll link the fajas that I got and that I used during my healing process down below. I also still wear my faja after a year just because I want, like, a faja helps shape your body and it's good for the maintenance of your BBL as well too. So, the faja that I actually wear often is also from Snatch Bands. I do need to go and get my other ones altered because they are a little big. But definitely getting a quality faja is definitely worth the investment for achieving the results that you are looking for. What advice would I give someone going alone for surgery? I would just say make sure that you're safe. Safety is always going to be the first thing. Next, I went with my sister, but yeah, that's really my only advice is just kind of like, you know, make sure that you're safe. They do come and pick you up from the airport and they bring you back to the airport. They take you to all of your appointments and stuff like that. And when I say they, I mean the recovery home. They pick you up from the airport, they take you back to the airport when it's time for you to go, and they take you to all of your appointments. They're going to pick you up after surgery, they're going to drop you off before surgery, like they're going to do all of that. And I didn't do like any sightseeing or anything like that, so I stayed my butt in the recovery home and watched TV and ate some snacks. How was the language barrier? So the language barrier really wasn't even that bad because a lot of the employees do speak English. If they don't, then there's someone around who does speak English. Also, Google Translate is going to be your best friend. I think I only had one nurse that didn't speak English, but I think she was interning and she was new. So, yeah, I just used Google Translate and we did that back and forth and the job got done. So, and they understand like simple stuff like pain. They understand just like the simple stuff. Like, I knew I was getting on their nerves when I was in the hospital, because after surgery you have to stay in the hospital for a day. But I was clicking that little nurse button. Pain. Y'all gonna give me all of the pain medicine. Every time I felt a little inkling of pain, and they give you a little button, pressing that button. I don't, you know, they knew what was up. I don't want to feel nothing. And I didn't. While I was in the hospital, I ain't feel nothing. I was pressing that button so much. They was coming in, putting that pain medicine in my IV. I need that. Thank you. Would you go back for a second round? No, girl. No. One, the main reason why I'm saying no is because I am honestly satisfied with my results. I'm satisfied with my results, and I just want to build on top of my results. And that's why I'm starting my fitness journey. Woo. Dr. Plaza also recommends that you do start a fitness journey, just to keep your results maintenance and always looking up to par. If you guys want to come along with me for my journey, my fitness journey, just type fitness journey in the comment section below, and I would definitely be glad to take you guys with me. I feel like I have already started, and I've been posting on my surgery page, which I'll put my surgery page right here, so that you guys can follow me and also come along. I feel like I'm more active on my Instagram, whereas on YouTube, the goal is to start uploading at least once a week. And if I don't, be on my ass, like, comment, like, sis, where the video at? Where the video at? You know what I'm saying? Like, I need y'all to be on my ass. I'm excited to start back, and I'm excited to like the little things that I want to do is, like, I want to build my thighs. Like, I want my thighs to be a little thicker, and my stomach to be a little smaller. I've gained weight, so that's why I was telling y'all, like, don't let these folks think that y'all cannot gain weight after getting a BBL, because you can. Like, and I'm not saying that I've gained too much weight. Like, at surgery, I was 140. 1 year post-op, I am 145. So I've gained 5 pounds. But baby, that's a lot. That's a lot. So after surgery, my waist was a 27 and my hips were a 42. 1 year post-op, my waist is a 28 and my hips is a 43. So I've gained an inch around. Simply because, you know, I've gained weight. And I'm okay with the 43 hips. I ain't even gonna lie. I'm okay with that. However, my goal waist is like a 25. So, I'm getting in the gym. And if you guys want to see BBL maintenance videos, please let me know in the comment section down below. And comment BBL maintenance. I'm also looking into doing, like, wood therapy and cavitations, just to help, you know, get them results looking like, you know, so I can start looking like a snack. Well, I look like a snack now. I ain't even gonna cap me down, but, you know, just better results. This year, I am bettering me for sure, in many different ways. Yeah, girl. And my last question is, do you have any words of encouragement? I would say, sis, you got this. If this is something that you are deciding to do, you definitely got this. I would say that this is a life-changing experience. You are investing into yourself, so it's going to be like certain things that you're going to have to change, like your old ways. Like, if you have some, like, toxic old ways, I would recommend, like, changing it. It's really a journey, and, like, people just feel like it's just like, oh, I got my body done. No, like, having a BBL is, sorry, having a BBL is literally life changing. Like, you gain new people, you lose people, because you invested into yourself and your looks, you have the opportunity to walk in different rooms that you probably never would have been able to walk in before. So you have to elevate You upgraded your body, so you're finna upgrade your life. You have to upgrade your attitude. You have to upgrade everything, sis, okay? The people you fuck around, like the people you hang out with, you have to upgrade them, because what I've experienced is like a lot of people will say that they're happy for you, and I'm getting emotional. A lot of people will say that they're happy for you and they really just jealous of you. And that's just real. Like, and especially coming from somebody like myself who is just like really humble, like I don't do too much. I really say to myself, child, why I'm getting emotional? I don't even know. What is wrong with me? Anyway, so I'm really somebody who really just kind of like stay to myself. I love living a private life. People are gonna want to be in your business. Like, it's exhausting, you know, especially like when you're used to just like living life privately, you know what I'm saying? Like, now you get stared at more. People have so many questions. Men are rude. You know, I constantly get asked by men all the time, is that yours? Did you get your body done? And I'll be like, nigga, did you pay for it? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, they're rude, especially like because I work in nightlife too, though. So I get so much just like, ugh. And then so men are so used to, I feel like people in general are so used to seeing women with BBLs only on social media that they're astonished. Like, they're like, when they see somebody who actually invested in themselves and, you know, achieved the look of excellence, you know what I'm saying? So you really have to be careful with the environments that you place yourself in after getting a BBL. Like, girl, you really have to like upgrade your life. And not even just, you know, random people, but people in your everyday life. Like, is this covering? Oh, people in your everyday life, like family. Like, so you have to really like change. Like, you really have to change. And change for the better. Change for like the best version of you. You invested in yourself so that you can be the best version of yourself, and so that you can walk into rooms and open doors with opportunities that you would have never thought that you would have been able to do. So that is my words of encouragement. Change for the better. And do that thing, sis. No more bare minimum. No more. Because you're not bare minimum. No more. And I'm not just preaching to y'all. Like, I'm preaching to myself. No more bare minimum. You didn't spend the bare minimum and invest in your body and invest in your looks. You didn't go cheap with that. That's not cheap. So no more bare minimum. And that's my words of encouragement. No more bare minimum. And walk with pride. I ain't saying being cocky. I'm not saying like, you know, shun people because you think that you're better than them or anything like that. But just upgrade your life. That's it. So that's all for my video today. I'm sorry I got super emotional with y'all. You guys, I was not trying to do all of that. At the end of this video, I will be putting some videos of my current body and what I look like, because I know that's what y'all want to see. But yeah, that concludes this video. I love you guys so much. I really want you guys to be on my butt about posting here more and being more interactive with you guys, because that is definitely my goal for 2023, is to build my family, like build Bay Game, because like, what's up? I have so many things in store for this year, and I just feel like you guys deserve to come along with me. You guys have been rocking with me for super, super long, and I need to treat y'all. I love you guys so much. Thank you. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe to this video if you guys like it. If you guys want to know anything, my comment section is always open, and I really do my best, try my best to answer everybody's comments. I feel it in my chest at night. I want